The first step is to go to the Adobe Express homepage, which looks something like this. If you're not there, if you find yourself on a page that looks something like this, you're probably on the Adobe landing page. To get to Express, just click on the Adobe Apps icon in the top right corner and choose Adobe Express. That will take you to the landing page. Now at this point, it's also very helpful to have some kind of plan for your video. I have mine developed in a storyboard that I'll be referencing as I create my video. From the landing page, at the top, underneath What Do You Want to Make, select Video. This will present you with a lot of different options. These are all different sizes and formats designed for social media platforms. For instructional videos, I recommend the Video option. Hover your mouse over Video and you'll have two options: Create from Scratch and Browse Templates. Now you're welcome to check out the templates, and they are really cool, folks. But when you're just getting started, sometimes they can be a little over the top and end up getting you pretty confused. So I'm going to recommend, if you're a beginner, to create from scratch. So let's click there. Now let me show you around this space. Over on the right side of your screen, you see a big white rectangle. I'm going to refer to that as our canvas. Down below that is what we'll refer to as our timeline. This is where we'll be building out the different scenes in our video. Express gets you started with one scene, which when you click on it is what you actually see up in the canvas. Now our scene is blank. If we wanted to add a scene, we'd click here, Add Scene, and we'll do that in a little bit. This button here plays your video. So if you want to at any time see what your video is going to look like when it's actually played back, that's where you'd click. And this is a little scrubber bar that lets you drag through each screen, and it helps you make some fun little detailed tweaks along the way. These little bars that you see, these gray bars at the end of each scene, allow you to make the scene shorter or longer. And it will always show you how long your scene is in this little, that little box that appears right at the top of the right edge. So right now that scene is 7 seconds. Okay, I'm gonna make it a little bit shorter. And you also have these three dots here that will reveal more information and more options about your scenes. We'll start unpacking all this stuff over here to the left once we start doing a little work. At the top of your screen, there's an option for theme. I'm going to click on theme, and it will show me a whole bunch of different color palettes, and I'm going to choose a color palette that I like. Now, over on the right again, above the canvas, select background color. Now it's going to show me the color palette that I just selected, and it's going to allow me to pick one of those as my background color. I'm going to choose this dark color here. Okay, so now as you can see, my scene has turned this dark blue-gray color. I'm keeping in mind what I want my first scene to look like, and I have a title in mind. And so what I'm going to do now is add some text to my scene. On the far left side, I'm going to click on text, and you'll see that there are some pre-formatted text options that you can choose as a template and edit, or you can add your own text. I'm going to look around a little bit, maybe down here in the headlines area. Next to headlines, I'm going to select view all, and I'm going to choose this and see how this looks. So it places the text right on the screen for me. I can click on the words and change them. I can click on the corner and make it bigger. and move it to another part of the page. Okay, now let's talk about color. With regards to color, we want to be sure that we have a strong contrast between the background, this dark blue-gray, and the foreground, which is this shape, the rectangle shape, and the text. I'm not feeling good about this contrast. It doesn't look so great to me, and that's an accessibility concern. So I'm going to click on the text, and when I click on it, you see that the text panel opens automatically on the left. I can highlight the red text, click fill, and choose a different color. I'm going to actually go over to the custom tab and do like a pale yellow. Now I'm going to click on that black text and on the left side select the fill and select the white out of my page theme. Now for this rectangle, it's a little bit different. Let me click on it again. The text panel opens, but you'll see down here it says shape and it's highlighted. That's what drew my attention to it. When I click on the arrow next to shape, that's how I get to the shape fill color. And again, I want to change that to a pale yellow. Okay, so there's my first scene. I'm now going to click on Add Scene to go to my next scene and build this one out. For this one, I had a plan for a video with a little text. So that means I want to find a video. On the far left of my screen, I'm going to click on Media. When you go to Media, you can browse through the photos by clicking Photos at the top and videos that Adobe Express has provided for you. If you have a free account, you'll want to select photos and videos that do not have the premium icon in the lower right corner. If we select one of those, you'll see that it says it's a premium asset and you'll be prompted to upgrade when you publish your video. So we do not want that. So I'm just going to click on it and then press delete on my keyboard and get it out of there. Let's go back to the media area on the far left and enter a search term to find a video. And when I find a video that I want to try out, I will click on it and it will populate over into the canvas area. Now from here, I can choose to crop the video if I want. So if I don't want the whole slide taken up by the video, I can do something like this. Or, let's see, I could go like this. I think I'm going to leave it like that. And then I want to add some text underneath the video. So over on the far left, I'll select text from the far left column. And this time, instead of using one of these templates, I'm simply going to click on Add Your Text at the top, drag it down, and change the text, and center it. Okay, so I've got two of my scenes done now, and now I'm going to click Add Scene to add a new one. So now I want something that's going to convey a happy feeling. I'm going to go back to the media option in the far left column and this time click on photos. I'm going to enter the search happy face and select a photo, position it somewhere on the page. And now I want some text next to the image. So again, far left column, I'll select text. Add your text. I'll make that a little bit smaller. Okay, so my third scene is done. At the bottom in my timeline, again, I'm going to just keep going and add a new scene. This time I want to convey disappointment or sadness. So I'm going to look for a video this time and see what I can find. I'm not loving anything that I'm finding here. I'm not finding a video that I like. But you know what? I found a video over at pexels.com and I have that downloaded to my computer. So I'm going to add that into Adobe Express. To do that, click on Upload from Device in the top left corner. Select the video file and it will load right into your scene. Pretty cool, right? Keep in mind, you can also upload video clips that you've recorded from your webcam or your phone this way also. Like I did before, I'm going to crop that video a bit. Click on the background, go over to text in the far left corner, select add your text, drag it down a bit, drag it down to the bottom, and edit the text. Make it a bit smaller. And I'm done with that scene. In the timeline, go to the far right and select Add Scene. This time I'm looking for a video or a photo of a dandelion to convey the idea of a wish. So again, in the far left column, I'll select Media and then Video. Enter my search term. Find a video that I like, see how it plays, be sure you like it. Okay, and I want to add some text over this video this time. So I'll go back to text, select add your text. I'm going to put it over here. Again, make it a bit smaller. I want to add one more box of text. And now I'm on my final scene. I'm going to add my final scene. Now I'm just going to repeat those same steps again to add my final scene with one more video. Okay, that's going to be my final video that I add, and I'm not going to put any text on this one. So those are my six scenes in my video that comprise my visual track. Our next step is going to be to add the voice narration or the audio track, and I'll show you how to do that in the next video.